came from a textbook. I believe it was Eden. All right, so first question. I have the answer hidden. That's why it's down so low on the paper, on the page. A blood gas analyzer measures all of the following except
A.
A, very good. Components of a laboratory blood gas analyzer include which of the following? A three-electrode measuring chamber, reagent or buffer solutions, calibrating gas tanks, waste container. D, letter D. Which blood gas analyzer electrode uses a separate reference electrode? O2, pH, Clark, bicarbonate. One of them has two electrodes where it has a reference electrode and then actually measures it. Clark? No, it's not Clark. No, it's not Severing House. pH.
That's two.
There's two electrodes. One is a reference electrode, and then the actual measurement electrode.
What's the reference electrode for? Just for the control?
The reference electrode probably has a known pH. And then it just compares the difference between the two to come up with what the actual pH is. Does this tell us? The reference or half cell produces a constant potential regardless of sample pH. The difference in potential between the two electrodes is proportional to the hydrogen ion concentration of the sample, which is displayed on a voltmeter calibrated in pH units. There you go, Ledger.
Thanks.
To measure PCO2, blood gas analyzers use what electrode? Severing House. If you have severe CO2, you've got a problem. When conducting ABG analysis in the laboratory, obvious signs of pre-analytical error include all of the following except. So pre-analytical, like before you even put it in the machine, what could have happened that'll mess up the values?
Air bubbles.
Air bubbles.
Clotting.
Clotting.
Unmixed
sample. Yeah, what would gross dilution be? I don't know about that one. So gross dilution is the exception. So air bubbles mess it up, clotting messes it up, not mixing the sample correctly messes it up. Oh, it says D. Says refer to the manufacturer's literature. Which of the following are true about a blood gas analyzer's waste fluids? A strong disinfectant should be added to the waste fluid containers. Waste fluids should be handled as if they were blood samples. Waste fluids should be treated as potentially infectious. All of them. D. What is the process of testing a new blood gas analyzer to confirm a manufacturer's claims? gas analyzer. It's the only one that looks familiar to me. I would say automated calibration. Okay? Let's see what it says. It says performance validation. Oh, that's okay. How is the accuracy of a blood gas analyzer determined? Examine the repeatability of the analyzer's results. Compare the analyzer's measurements to known values. Adjust the offset or balance of the instrument. Adjust the gain or slope of the instrument. Okay, compare the analyzer's measurements to known values. What media are used to calibrate a blood gas analyzer's gas electrodes? All right, so all three electrodes? I would say C, because we know that the gas comes from a cylinder, and that's how it gets calibrated. And pH doesn't get calibrated like that. It uses the buffer solutions. I'm going to go with C, let's see. Yeah, so most units, media used to calibrate the gas electrodes are precision mixtures of O2 and CO2. How do you know that the output of a blood gas analyzer is both accurate and linear across the range of measured values? A calibration procedure must measure what? And the answer is D, parameters with known input values at 2 points. How often should blood gas calibration verification by control media take place? Yeah, 2 levels every 8 hours. Statistically derived limits for internal quality control of blood gas samples are usually set at what appropriate level?
2 standard deviations.
Very good. 2 standard deviations from the mean. When inspecting an internal quality control plot for blood gas analyzer, you notice several data points sporadically appearing outside the 2 standard deviation range. This represents what type of analytic error? We didn't talk about that. I don't know. Do you guys want to guess?
B.
You guess B? Bias and systematic error?
Yeah.
Error?
Why not?
That doesn't count. He said it as we saw the answer.
All the opposite.
All right, so that's not on the test. What about this one? Total instrument error or inaccuracy of a blood gas analyzer equals which of the following? Oh, no, that's not on the test either.
B.
This is the random and systematic? A. Okay, factors contributing to imprecision or random errors during blood gas analysis include all of the following except. I guess statistical probability is the only one I don't recognize. Could you contaminate a sample with liquid heparin or with an air bubble?
Yes.
If the buffers are, somebody puts bleach in the buffer and it's contaminated, or if you don't handle the sample correctly. So I'm saying C. B. all right, so you analyze a blood gas control and it falls outside the 2 standard deviations. How could you verify that this was a random error? Do you repeat the analysis on a different analyzer? Compare the control to an actual sample, or rerun the control sample a second time?
Mm-hmm. B.
I would say number three only, but that's not a choice, so.
I don't like to, normally compare it with an actual patient.
Yeah, we don't know an actual patient sample, so number two is definitely out.
So B?
So B. Yay!
You got one.
All right, so here we are, running a control, and CO2 is outside the two standard deviations. Over the last six control samples run, what corrective action would you consider at this time? I mean, six samples, that can't be rerun it and check it. Definitely repair or replace, something's not working right.
So B.
So would it be B?
Yeah.
Okay. Good job. What is the quality control procedure of analysis and reporting on externally provided control media with unknown values? Should we pick a fancy word?
Yeah.
Performance validation? What do you say?
Automated calibration.
Automated calibration? Remember, the external controls are when the state sends a blood sample to all the hospitals? So that would be performance, or would that be proficiency?
They all look good.
C! All right, are we done yet? Oh my God, how do you come up with so many questions?
Oh, you gave us the answer, say.
All right, very good.
Good job.
All right, so let me give you your review for your final exam.
Yay.